Welcome back. So, we're going to play some relay chess tonight for any and all who are up for it. The site, as always, can be found at relaychess.org. Just unleash the madness is the subtitle. So, rules for those unfamiliar. Pieces, including the king, not including pawns, inherit movement from the natural powers of any piece protecting them. Castling is performed by moving the king on top of the rook, because what you'll find is that when it comes time to castle, the king is able to move castle. So the standard moving of a king two squares over does not count as castling, it counts as moving the king two squares. If you have a bishop defending your rook, the rook can move like either a rook or a bishop. None of that's transitive, by the way. Alright, we got a 1 minute anonymous seek out there. Well, anonymous don't see rated games. Okay. That's worth noting. Nice. That's a really elegant tune upon summoning of this game. Alright. So, oh, I forgot my mouse doesn't work that well for bullet chess. That can make this bullet relay chess that much more exciting. Alright, so my queen's defending my knight, guys. Oh, you saw it. So far I haven't hung anything just yet. And you'll find that a lot of relay chess openings do just devolve into standard chess openings. Okay, so this knight threatens, like, to take either one of these knights. There we go. We have a standard exchange. There's no way for registered users to challenge unregistered users at the moment. Ah, a scale. For those who are able to hear it. Okay, bishop takes is played. I'm gonna see if I can lure out the queen. Oh, the queen has been lured out. Alright. Actually, yeah, let's just develop the rook. And develop the bishop. Okay, free stuff. Just have to be a little bit careful here. Alright. So now that knight moves like a rook. Rook knights are... That's a dangerous, dangerous piece for me to be staring down here. Tough break. Them's the breaks. I managed to win this on time. So yeah, that's relay chess. Whoa. Oh, we've got Mr. Corrupted out there seeking a game. How can we turn down this opportunity? Alright. Let's, I don't know what piece to develop. Man, I can't believe I'm doing a normal development. Or am I? Yeah, it's just getting exciting there. Alright. Gonna go with the double fianchetto opening. Oh, this could be risky. Oh, forgot about that. Alright, I guess I'll block the center. Yeah, this could go horribly wrong. Or it could go okay, I'm not sure. Okay, so I'm gonna exchange
Okay.
knights here and probably get my queen out of the way. There aren't very many safe squares. Nah, this looks safe enough. Who am I to fear stuff? If I could just put my bishop over there, just imagine all the fun shenanigans I could have. Yeah, this is gonna get to be a really messy game here in just a second. Actually, you know, I forgot how well defended some of my things are. Bishop D7 looks fun. Yeah, I can't turn this down. This looks too fun to not play. Oh, there's the trick. So, yeah, his bishop is able to move like a rook or a queen. I probably want to do something. I forgot about that. Let's run. Let's bravely run away. Yeah, I suppose bishop to, or knight to e3 was defended against multiple ways here. Wow, this looks dicey. This looks way dicier than it needs to be. Yeah, let's ease up some of this pressure. And actually, this seems like a good square for the knight. Let's put it there. I was gonna put it on f4, but it doesn't have so much movement on f4 as it does on g5. Okay. Decisions, decisions. Castling by hand. I get to move my king through check. Because that's how relay chess works, apparently. No, that's deliberate. Okay. What do I think of this? I think this looks fun. I think that I actually end up on the better end of this capturing race. Ever so slightly. Right, so he takes my knight, I take his queen. He takes my queen, I take his bishop. Yeah, it looks really weird to see two dark squared bishops. Okay, he protects the pawn. Let's advance this pawn. I was gonna attempt some shenanigans and just realized it doesn't work at all. That's sad. All right, let's move the bishop forward. Here we go. I have an active king out of nowhere. That was the plan. King D5. Surprising plan, perhaps not an effective one. Right. Oh, that's how. Okay. Apparently, I have to run.
Check.
All right, let's take one of
Check.
those and run and activate stuff. Oh, this doesn't look so good on the timer, does it?
Check. Check.
Oops. My bad. Well, there goes my rating. Oh well, what can you do? Hey, look, a 5-minute seek. Surely I can't lose at 5-minute. Yeah, flying kings are fun. Alright. Let me attempt something more energetic this time. Knight h6. F5. F takes e4. Check! Ha! Didn't see that coming. Oh crap, I forgot that's playable. I didn't see that coming. No, I mean, that's part of the game. If the flag's there, you have to use it. I just happened to lose track of the time last game. Ooh, okay, well that's an unwelcome visitor. It actually is attacking something, too. I guess I'll have to take it. Oh, I can't take that. That's mean. Alright, let's run. Well, that's no good either. Oh well, I put up a good fight. Not really. GG. Alright. Well, that was a thing. Let's put 3-2 out there. Just to demonstrate that increment actually does work. So, yeah. Apparently that's me losing 3 games in a row. So. I don't get bonus points or anything for that. But whatever. We'll take it. At least it feels like 3 games. It was probably... I don't even remember how many it was. When it's spectating... Oh, I forgot. Yeah, no, I did in some small way help with spectating working. I think Mr. Corrupted also helped considerably with that. So, yeah, no, I think that was added a month or two or three ago. It's just I haven't had the occasion, or just haven't come back here in a while. Like, I think I got it to a state where it was kind of working or something, and then Mr. Corrupted fixed my bugs or something to that effect. But yeah, we got spectating. It's pretty cool. Not gonna lie. Suppose... Since I'm lounging in the lobby a bit, let's get that music going. Yeah, there's unfortunately never time to continue on the things that are to be done. But no, it's really awesome that it works as far as it does. And we have a community Discord. Oops, I clicked on the Discord and this brings up the Discord app. Yeah, if you click on the Discord button here, that's our permanent Discord channel. Any and all are welcome there. I know people were asking lately, when are people going to be playing on here, so I decided, why not play some tonight? Accounts are free to register, so there's no fees or anything associated with it. I think anonymous people can play anonymous people, but in order to play, and... Unfortunately, I can't put out a rated challenge for anonymous people to see. And I can't put out an anonymous only challenge or anything like that, but that's okay. If people want to play, there's no reason not to create an account and play some games and figure out just how good you are. So I did find it silly the other day. So National Master John Chernoff, going by the name of Zugaddict, created a whole bunch of puzzles for, I would actually say compositions. He created one to demonstrate the use of the skewer, and just basically figured out how many skewers you could possibly fit into a given chess problem, where white skewers black, and then black is threatening to counter skewer, but then white counter skewers, and it was cool to see that. And then he's showing some things about here's a pin, but then this piece gets pinned, and yeah, I really think that he went pretty far out into the range of compositions in terms of what he created. And unfortunately, there's not yet a section on Lee Chess for compositions. Oh, hey, look, an anonymous challenge. Well, without further ado, I suppose if Dinamir is not accepting my challenge, I will take this anonymous challenge and run with it. Here we go. E4. All right. Threatening bishop somewhere. Queen somewhere. Queen somewhere else. You know Alekhine's great. Oh, shoot. One second. There we go. So my knight threatens his knight. But now my knight no longer threatens his knight. My knight can move like a bishop. Let's see. How else do I make this interesting? Let's try to play for d4 and just try to exert some central influence. All right, so now I've got a knight bishop and a bishop knight and so forth. Here, this looks fun. All right, let's take knight
Check.
takes knight. Wait, my other knight doesn't attack that. Let's make things interesting. Bishop a6, threatening knight takes queen. Will he see it? If he does see it, what's he gonna do about it? So I unveiled this discovery here. Oh, that protects the bishop. That's clever. That's too clever. Whatever, I'm gonna take the bishop anyway. All right. Yeah, it's been a long time since we've done relay chess. And I was thinking, maybe I should play some shogi, and then I realized, wait, I have a better idea than shogi. Let's play something I'm good at. So note to castle, play king takes rook. Don't play king to g1 or king g8. All right. Let's threaten to break this open, even though it's an empty threat. Really, I just need to play d5. All right. So, like I said, you need to play like, need to move your king on top of the rook, instead of moving it there. So I'll donate a few moves. I don't care. All right. Okay. Oh wait, the knight defends the bishop now. I could use a light squared bishop here. Not really, but I just want the excuse to move it like that. Okay. Let's move this over. pawns do not relay. Only everything else. So now I've got a bishop that moves like a queen, which is kind of lame if you think about it. Knights tend to be pretty cool, but bishops are ranged pieces, so this might work out for me in the long run. Let's expose this. I'm not convinced. You'll have to show me what this is about. Mating attacks are surprisingly difficult, because pieces are pretty easy to mobilize. So he sacked a knight for this attack. Oh, I can't do rook takes c8. Let's see, what's the threat? Rook takes rook, bishop takes... Yeah, let's put this here.
Check.
So, oh, shoot, he sees it. He sees my subtle point. He actually makes a really good point of his own. Okay, let's bail.
Check.
Alright. Yeah, we're gonna bail this way. This is actually gonna be a tricky endgame. Which is not good considering that I'm down on time. Again. But I think we have an increment, so I'm not completely hosed. Okay. This will work out somehow. Let's defend that. Make subtle threats. Keep our queen on an open space. Yeah, thankfully there's this increment here. Okay. Let's just keep marching forward. Wait, am I down a pawn? I'm down a pawn. How crazy do I feel? Probably not too crazy. Right. I forgot how useless some mobile pieces can be.
Check. Check.
Yeah, okay. This is tricky.
Check.
Okay, let's run. That's not very good. Let's run further. Yeah, I made this really complicated for myself.
Check.
Okay, I'm in check.
Check.
I'm in check. Free pawn. Details do matter. Well, I think I have to try that. Yikes.
Check.
This is not very good. Let's run.
Check.
Free queen. Just in time to
check.
Oh. Okay, let's run up here again. Worked pretty well last time. Okay, then over here. Okay. Shit. I'm in time trouble. Just a little bit of time trouble here. Alright, let's take that. Oh dear. This could get bad.
Check.
Oh, that actually works for me. Yeah, unfortunately, the king does not defend the queen in that sense. I'm pretty sure all of us missed mate at one point. Yeah, unfortunately, like, that was not a recursive thing, so the king... Although the queen defended the king there, the king did not in turn defend the queen, which was defending the king. If that makes any sense. Another point that Zug showed me in one of our previous relay chess games, we'd actually played this one on Lee Chess, just simulating what were the Lee Chess, or the relay chess rules, simulated on an examine board that just allows you to freely move the pieces. I forgot we had this. This is pretty cool. Yeah, if it were recursive, that'd be crazy. But it doesn't even allow you to, like, have a rook defending a bishop, defending the rook, and so forth. So the piece that's defending is not itself defended. One really tricky thing Zug showed me once is that you could actually interrupt the defense by interposing a piece. And that interposition it breaks the relaying chain. So it can prevent a piece from moving the way it would ordinarily be moving. If that makes any sense. Which it doesn't, but... So yeah, it's cool to see on the king side there, there's the two knights lined up, each ready to pounce on an opponent who makes a mistake. I still have to find... I assume that one d4 has got to be a good opening. If nothing else, it's got to be interesting, but I'm sure one d4 actually allows for positions where you don't have knight f3 and knight f6. Or even if those moves do happen, it doesn't have the same exact effect. Why was the... Oh. Yeah, Mr. Corrupted pointed that out. I didn't even notice that. But you're saying the wrong king is highlighted when a king's in check or something. I don't remember this moment, but surely you're correct, because both of you saw it and I missed it. But it's nothing that's not on our agenda not fix or something. Basically what I'm saying is if we find an issue, I'll probably fix it within a month or something, or a week. Really depends on my work schedule and other stuff, but yeah, if you find an issue, I'll certainly fix it. We still actually have been working with some people to make Stockfish more reliable across various platforms, but still playing variants. Alright, do we not have Knight Takes Knight? We do have Knight Takes Knight. Okay. Here's the tricky part. Rook takes queen. The rook can move like a king, so... that's pretty sneaky. Alright, now we got a bishop that moves like a rook. Also, we have a rook that moves like a bishop. Oh, or could just take the bishop, and now all white has to worry about is pieces that move like kings, or rooks, or pawns. But yeah, having this diversity in the way that white's pieces move actually has some benefit, though I don't know how much. But black's attacks are kind of predictable, given that his attacking pieces are the rooks and the king. So of course the fun thing to do is make it look like black's backed into a corner or something, and then black's king just jumps across a rank or a file. So, yep, that's a well-played bishop. See, if black had a queen on c8 instead of a king, then rook takes bishop could happen. Yeah, it's always fun to just dash the king across a wide distance. You know, I wonder, maybe fianchettoing. Actually, maybe one knight h3 is okay. I'm trying to think if there's some more clever way to try to activate the pieces. Unfortunately, we have a battery here. Pins don't quite work the way they would in a normal chess game. Alright, are we gonna see? Yes, we are. There it is, bishop f8.
Check.
This might not be going so well for black.
Check.
Yep, GG. Well played. I forgot I could use arrows and highlights and all that fun stuff. Let's put a seek out for a 3-minute game. Yeah, this game is pretty out there. I think you hung in there pretty well, though. It's not an easy game. Can you imagine, though, making relay chess puzzles? And there being a relay chess stockfish. At one point, I had the imagination to try to do something with stockfish and relay chess. At another point, I'll probably have that imagination again. It's hard. Just making stockfish plays variants in general, but this one that involves changing how the pieces move really just completely overhauls how the game works. At least one property remains true, that in a given position, the list of moves is the same as in repetitions of that position. Alright, we're playing Eat That Booty! It's a clever name. Maybe. Alright, 1 knight a6. Got him confused. Maybe. Here, let's play knight b4. Yeah, I did say that about Crazy House, and it was true. That in Crazy House, we had to patch so many bugs after Crazy House was initially released. No variant has caused so many bugs for all the variants as Crazy House did. But in the end, it was worth it because the engine was both popular, useful, and very well received. And it won the first World House Crazy House Championship for computers. So, and got a number of people on board the project too because of it, and basically made the engine more popular. Not even that popularity was the goal, because it wasn't, but yeah. Relay Chess could be, you never know. It's a pretty awesome variant. And that's why I did help install the site a little bit and try to make things work as best as I could, even though I'm still learning Angular. Oh man.
Check.
There we go. Check. Let's see. Should I play King D6? Would that be a good developing move, guys? Oh man. I'm actually seriously contemplating it. It's the most fun move on the board, that's for sure. At least until he plays C5. Yeah, I guess I gotta play a normal developing move. Unfortunately. I would have played it if it weren't like the worst move on the board and getting mated in one, basically. You know, if it were a little bit better than that, I would have gone for it. But then, like, at the last second, I changed my mind and I'm like, you know, it actually loses the game by force, so maybe not. Honestly, no, I think I have to I don't remember if we have the broken version up. In any event, I think the next evolution has to be a working C version of it. Gosh darn it. So yeah, I'm not threatening anything basically, so I have to do this. This helps all my pieces activate better. Okay, then we'll develop like this, I suppose. This is the most predictable development pattern ever. But yeah, I have to just focus on getting it working in C and C++. Fine, I guess we'll exchange pieces. It's a good thing that he offered that exchange because I forgot his knight can move like a queen. So it could have like even theoretically gone so far as this. Okay, note that this is not transitive, so the one in front cannot go to H7. It's only the one in the back that can move to H7. Which he's no doubt contemplating right here. All right, I'll stick with the boring move. Queen e8. Setting up the boring, obvious threat. But also, you know, if somebody makes an AI to play this game, it doesn't even have to be Stockfish, too. It could be some other general purpose sort of chess AI. Here, let's. Oh, that would undefend H7. Let's push H7. Yeah, and then maybe I'll move my king over to F8. I'm not sure. Maybe I'll play some of my other pawns forward. Hey, welcome to Relay Chess. Oh no, we're playing a special chess game that Lee Chess, this is just too advanced for Lee Chess. Lee Chess wouldn't know what to do with it. Oh man, I'm trying to debate how tricky to be here. Here, I'm actually going to play that, which is not tricky at all. Let's see. You'll see that some of the highlighted squares the pieces can go to are not your normal chess moves. Alright. Just gonna keep pushing all these pawns until something positive happens. Right. Four pawns. Here we go. Basically what I'm doing is a recipe for disaster, but I don't know. Well, kind of, but more just a new variant, a new way of playing chess. Which I could demonstrate if only the opportunity arises to play a silly move that doesn't look like a chess move. Okay. Here we go. King B4. You might ask, what is this move? How is that legal? It's because this is relay chess and none of the rules make any sense. So, yeah, if my queen defends my king, the king can move like a queen. And likewise, if any piece defends any piece, the sort of moves-like rule applies to other pieces. So here my threat was king takes c4 check, and then he moves his king, and then I play like king c1 mate. That was my threat here. Yeah, so basic primer of the rules. Pieces inherit movement from the natural powers of any piece protecting them. And castling is played by playing king takes rook. Yeah, it's pretty confusing, not gonna lie. Actually, we could see Railbird play a game. So, I've lost a few games to Corrupted. Corrupted is now the number one ranked player on the site. And yeah. I could go back to the lobby too and seek my own game. Maybe. Probably. There we go. I found the lobby, guys. I'm so good. So. Yeah. Although, well, no, there are enough players out here that in theory I could get an opponent. Yeah, I seriously doubt that other sites are going to put in the effort to code this correctly as we did. So, also they don't have the cool music. But yeah, here's the site. Unleash the madness. All right, we have an opponent, guys. Right, D4. Man. I'm gonna play knight H6. Just because I can. It's a good reason to make a move. All right, let's play G5. Again, just because we can. No, now the knight is defended by the bishop, so the knight defends the pawn. So progress is made. That pawn is kind of loose. I'd better defend it again. So now I'm threatening king H5. So, yeah, you better be careful because I might find a good use for King H5. It's probably not a useful move, though. All right, here, let's try moving out the other knight. There's no way this could backfire. Oh, he took it. But yeah, you can get some really interesting opening positions this way. That's for sure. Yeah, let's move the bishop out. And move this bishop out. Oh, the king was defended by the queen, so the king could move like a queen. Ooh, that was, yeah, that forgot this was defending the knight. So that knight springs pretty far. It's too risky. This is relatively safe. All right, maybe I should castle before everything goes to shit. So there we go. I have castled. Oh, I forgot. Now I can actually take this way and just get a whole mass of pawns on the side of the board. Oh, freeing up space for my pieces, but seems unwise. Okay. Yeah, I seem to be a bit cramped. Here. That actually alleviates some of my cramp and deals with the concrete threat of this by that. Let's see. Okay, let's open some lines. Sure, why not? Okay, I think I'm not hanging anything. Oh, yeah, no, this is the more advanced form of chess. I mean, what would you consider it or call it? This looks like chess to me. I mean, this is the future. All the chess masters are going to be playing this variant. I joke. No, it's still pretty cool. I mean, what would you call it then if it's not chess? It walks like a chess piece and talks like a chess piece. I even go so far in the title to call this relay chess rather than chess, but you're right, the game is listed under chess. I don't know what else I could list it under. It's not like Twitch officially recognizes this as something. Yeah, that's the trouble, is that, like, I don't know what I would list it under if not for chess. So this is the best arrangement I can come to. I mean, you see people playing like 1 minute chess, which I wouldn't consider that chess either. Arguably, everything that people play in the Western Hemisphere is not chess, because chess is actually the original game Shatranj that was played in Persia. So arguably anybody who's playing anything other than that isn't actually playing the game, which takes its name and takes check from Persian origin. So, I mean, technically anything that's being played outside of that Persian variant isn't normal chess. Or anything that, like, technically, this is actually Mad Queen chess, if you go by medieval rules.
Check.
Yeah, that king move is a bit aggressive. And it's true that other people do play chess variants on Lee Chess, and even they play Bughouse on chess.com. But you don't see people taking it off Twitch for that either. King e6 didn't quite work. It was clever. It just. There was something missing there. Yeah, no, I agree. That had been decided earlier. I mean, you see, like, Grandmaster Hansen playing Bughouse, and he lists his channel under chess. You see, Jan Lee, Crazy House World Champion playing chess, or Crazy House. They play that under the chess listing in Twitch. So one could argue none of those things are normal. One could argue that 1 minute chess doesn't really count either, and that some, I don't know, a lot of what goes on under blitz chess involves much more blundering, even to the point where people will play things and win on time in a lost position, which some people would not consider chess either. I mean, I get your point that this deviates quite far outside of the mad chess rules, but there's nothing better to list it under. All right, let's check out Railbird's game here.
Check.
Yeah, I don't know what else you'd list this under, though. Oh, right, yeah, the king was able to move two spaces there. That was clever. Ah, Counter-Strike. Yeah, no, that's a fantastic suggestion. To catch them entirely off guard. Or I could just list it under Hearthstone, because who watches Hearthstone? I'm making fun at expense of a friendly streamer who, does do Hearthstone fairly frequently and then talks about how people don't watch, but, I mean, yeah, we're certainly welcome to have disagreements in opinion about whether this is closer to Counter-Strike than it is to chess. No, he thinks that it would be better if I were to list this somewhere else, so as not to confuse people who are looking for actual chess. And he's got a point, but I'm just not sure that I can do anything constructive with it. Other than say, yeah, you're right, but I'm not sure what else I can do. Oh, we got a Seek out there. Here we go. Here we go. D4. Alright, H6. Subtle. I sense that he's up to something. Okay. I sense he's definitely up to something. Here, let's push this. Let's just push all the things. Close enough. No. Yes, no, this works. Yeah, but I'm not aware of any Twitch terms of service that require things to make sense according to the rules that you explain. That's the rub here, is that I don't have a better place to put this, and I think it does abide by Twitch terms of service. So I'm not sure how I can help you. If you can educate me about the terms of service and point out if I'm doing something wrong, I would appreciate that. Yeah, actually, that's a good point, Zish. All right, we're taking a pointer from the audience. Because we can. There's not a chess variance thing on Twitch, unfortunately. I mean, there's hardly even the audience for the game itself. Okay. Hopefully I'm doing this right, but probably not. Let's look at this constellation of pieces. Is this not beautiful? Oh, wow. I didn't even see knight takes e4. That is cool. Unfortunately, that's where all that ends. This is a really cool formation he's got going here, though. It's like kind of a Z. Oh, did I just push C5? Let's see what happens. So tempting, and yet so foolish. Okay, I'm gonna take back. Oh, knight. I just don't see these multi-move combinations, that's all. Alright. I feel kind of bad about this, but liquidating down the diagonal seems to be the most logical course of action here. Like this. Oh, that's clever. His king does not move like a knight. Wait, I've got knight takes knight here. I've got knight takes knight. But I've also got knight f5 check. How can I say no to this check?
Check.
Okay, there it is. That's the check, guys. Oh, crap. That's how I can say no to it. Always say no to the check, guys. All right. Well, that's just because we're playing too fast. You get some really trippy combinations in this game. But no, I'm just dead lost here. So I'll try to survive this. It's not going to go well.
Check.
I'm going to run. Yeah, no, I messed up. I played one bit too aggressively and just my tactics didn't work out. I don't know, even in standard chess, you can have two bishops on dark squares. They don't forbid that. It's just uncommon. Oh, crap. So, yeah, I should pay a little bit more attention. Hey. So, let's defend my king. Yikes. Oops. This is not good. Okay, we'll make a threat.
Check.
Oh dear. That's not very good. All right. Let's hit this pawn. Seem not to be winning this.
Check.
Okay.
Check.
Oh, that's checkmate. Dope. Well played. Yeah, no, I think ever since I played Knight F5, I was just down a piece, and it was much worse. I mean, you're welcome to an opinion, Seabass, but again, if you can't point out a rule that I'm violating, I'm not sure that I can help you. If you can show me a rule in the terms of service that says I can't do this, I'll more than be glad to abide by it and admit my mistake, but as it stands, I'm helping promote an interesting chess variant. In the same way that people play Crazy House and Bug House and other variants, and they list it under the chess game. I'm doing the same here. I don't even know if he's expecting positive feedback, but he's expecting some kind of feedback. He's probably expecting everybody to hate him, but I don't know. I'm more than willing to debate with him. I just don't know that I can help him. So, yeah, I seem not to be winning this the way that I used to be winning it. On the other hand, we saw some new tech there with the whole King E7, then vacating your back rank and just smashing the center. Okay. I mean, I could present facts too. Sky is blue. The moon is white. I mean, there are plenty of facts. It's true that this is not your standard Western mad chess or mad queen chess. It's true this is not Shatranj. It's true, this isn't Bug House, although sometimes it feels like it. Actually, facts are statements of truth, so a statement being false, that's not so much a fact or even an axiom as it is a proposition. Hey, sup? So I'm just apparently losing at this variant today. I'm being fortunate to remind myself that pieces move in non-standard ways in this variant. But yeah, honestly, I don't know. It seems like people are getting better at this. Like, I picked this game up pretty quickly, but people have evolved the tech to a point where this has gotten pretty challenging. Is there a board game where a human is better than a computer? Maybe Atomic Chess some other time, but thanks for the offer. I don't know very much in the way of Atomic Chess opening books or opening moves, so it tends not to be my variant of choice. I don't think that Lee Chess is going to pick this up anytime soon. This variant is pretty hard to implement. And so I have to give a lot of credit to Mr. Corrupted for making this possible. It's pretty amazing, to be honest. Also, you hear that background loop. Yeah, so we asked Zug to help make some sound or music for the game, and Zug was more than willing to contribute, so that was pretty cool. You know, even if you look back at his highlights, I think there was a session where he was composing the music for the site. And I I think he spent like an hour or two putting this together. Just going through a lot of ideas, ultimately settling on a really well-mastered version of this track here. And I wasn't actually pushing him to like try to create something perfect or anything of that sort. All we wanted was some nice music that can, like, actually, we're kind of looking for a sound set and or a theme song or something to play in a lobby. And so yeah, he provided us with the beautiful Game Has Started music and Game Has Concluded music, and as well as this lovely, lovely lobby theme. He originally had something much more energetic, and then we're like, Zug, that's fantastic. We could use that for our homepage. Yeah, no, this is really good. But yeah, in terms of something for a lobby, we finally settled on this, which is pretty cool. Cool. All right. Here we are playing against Anonymous. Nan plus or minus Nan. No, he's streaming last weekend. He's pretty active still. Here we go. H5. Because we can. Yeah, I still certainly hope he's okay. But I think he's doing fine. Yeah, he's probably also busy with Rosemary. And frankly, given this time of the academic year, probably is busy somewhat in academia. So yeah, he's been pretty active. a little bit selfishly, I've been asking him if he's going to play some more KSP for us. Because he seemed to have a lot of fun doing that, even though it caused some of us to tilt a little. But he had fun. I was pretty impressed that he managed to, I'm still not convinced that he actually did this. He might have faked it, but he did a moon landing. Which is pretty cool. Still hard to believe he did that. Just because a moon landing is a really incredible achievement in that game. I haven't even managed to get a craft into orbit yet. At some point, I do want to mess around with the Kerbal operating system. In particular, it'd be nice to have some sort of Twitch integration for a Kerbal operating system, so people can submit programs through the Twitch chat, and I don't know, I would run them on my computer, and we could see how far the rocket would get. It'd also be cool if there was some way to submit rockets through the Twitch chat, but, you know, what can you do? Alright, so let's defend the bishop with the other bishop. Yeah, it was amazing. That's the sort of result that's not going to be reproduced in a very long time. Yikes. Okay. We're gonna bravely run away. And then maybe try to find somewhere safe to put the king. Okay. Yeah, no, that still his moon landing, it's a work of art. I'm sure the developers would have wanted it to happen.
Check.
Yeah. And it's amazing how well you can do with these spacewalks landing. Like, you can fall from a really high height with the spacewalk and still be okay. Oh, okay, I see what you're saying, that he was allowed to spacewalk before landing on the surface because it was exactly at the right height to do the spacewalk. That makes sense. Yeah, I have two bishops on the same color because one of them moved like something other than a bishop to get onto the light squares. Right, so the point of relay chess is that pieces... Oh. Is my opponent trying to play like by normal chess rules? Is that what's going on here? If so, maybe I'll restrict myself a little bit. Because maybe my opponent's trying to make a point here. As long as he's sticking by the normal rules, I think I might restrain myself a little bit. Although I did play knight takes queen earlier, which is pretty ridiculous. So, yeah, I'm not sure. Like, I could go through tearing things up, but it seems like my opponent's trying to play by normal rules and then demonstrate a point to me that this isn't normal chess. Okay, never mind. Or maybe he's just getting acclimated to the way the pieces move. Yeah, probably the bishop moved like a rook at one point. Let's push this. See if he plays rook h4. Nope, that's not rook h4. Alright. Okay, let's develop the bishop. So here's the threat.
Check.
The king can move through check, as long as the king does not end its turn in check. It's worth noting. Oh, that's not check. Because even though this defends that, that doesn't enable the bishop to move like a rook. All right.
Check.
Oh, crap. Oh, I just made this challenging. I'm surrendering two pieces for a rook. Unless I want my king to run a lot. Oh, he's forced to play rook takes bishop. And I, in turn, am going to play queen takes rook. Just so I don't have any more of these illusions.
Check.
So... there's three consecutive checks for you.
Check.
Yep, the rook defends the king, which now can move like a rook. Okay, the king and the rook defend each other.
Check.
Point is that now I'm threatening king takes h2. Let's just push past that. Or, you know, king takes h4. We can do that too.
Check.
Alright, let's keep moving the king.
Check.
Go, king, go. You can do it. Alright.
Check.
There we go. Note that if he moves his king and I decide to go to the g-file, he can play knight takes rook to remove the check. So I have to do it this way. Also, that's checkmate. So, yeah. Good game. So the king cuts off the second rank, the rook cuts off the third rank, and the pawn has this. It's a tricky game, isn't it? Yeah, that was pretty cool. Like, I vaguely saw a few moves before that happened that some sort of idea similar to that might be possible. I didn't see actually that was a mate in one. But it did look very similar to the mating possibility I saw earlier. Somehow I thought his king was going to be able to escape that. What's even more cool is, like, when a king is escaping from a mating net, you would not believe how difficult it is to checkmate and ensnare a king that's well defended. Alright, good luck, Swish. And we're gonna open d4. Alright. Knight d2. Let's get the other knight out. Maybe just fianchetto. No, to castle, you do play king takes rook. Let's do this. He plays king g8. Oh, he did it right. Cool. That's one of the harder rules to get correct the first time. But yeah, I think my pawns do blunt the bishop a little bit. So I'll have to see if I can, like, sack mate somehow, although it's hard to do when the king has so much mobility. As opposed to nobility, which the king always has. But if the king is mobile, it's pretty damn hard to checkmate. You know, I wonder now. Let's just say, I wonder if a king were to lose its, or if a player were to lose their relaying powers if in check, I wonder how that would work. That could be an interesting spin on things. I think that would fundamentally change a lot of the game. But it could make for an interesting variant. And I'm not looking to complicate things any more than necessary. But I'm just trying to think what might help. I don't know. I'm trying to think of how to make this game even more interesting than it already is. Again, without the goal of complicating things, because that's a silly goal. All right. We're going to set up some subtle threats here. Maybe even play a good developing move. So, undoubtedly, the pro will see this coming. Also, it doesn't work, but he's going to see it coming. Also trying to think through, like, pawns are pretty cool in this game, but there's got to be a way to make them even more cool. All right, I'll exchange one set of knights. Okay, we'll take here. Now what? Now what indeed? Well, there's a fork. You come to a fork in the road, take it. Or if you find a fork in the road, take it, is the saying. Poor Zvish. It's running a little bit short on time. But we do have an increment to try to help balance that out.
Check.
There we go. Just develop my pieces. Nothing unusual here. Wow. Okay. I think my best move is this one. Oh, actually, taking the queen is better. My mistake. Ouch. Tough break for Zish. Wow. Yeah, it was a good game. Well played. Not the result he was looking for, but still an interesting game. Here we go. C4. Because why not? Bishop C3. Oh, can I do this on both sides? Alright, F4. Now, it's not quite as effectual on this side now that I think more about it. Because, reasons. Oh, I can't even do Bishop F3. Wow. Wow, look at that vision. So much blindness. Okay, so we're gonna play Knight F3. Alright. E4. Oh, this could be interesting. D4. Okay, we've used the fours, guys. Used all the fours. Although I could go for just moving everything to the fourth rank. There we go. G4. I wonder at what point this becomes excessive. Should probably calculate before moving or after moving.
Check.
Okay, we're in check, guys. King D3. Because we can. Strats are, I don't know. Strats are something. Okay. I think the center is starting to open up with my king in not the right position. So let's try to keep this closed.
Check.
All right. Take one of those. Hopefully I'm not dead.
Check.
Oh, that's check. Very clever. Okay, we'll take one of those too. This could be bad.
Check.
Yeah, so I've got to run. I'm gonna run here. Ah, who needs these pieces anyway?
Check.
All right, so I have to move my king again, unfortunately. Where do I go? I got plenty of options. Just having good options would be a nice thing too.
Um,
Yeah, let's go here. For subtle, subtle reasons.
Check.
Wait. I don't have King C2. Oh, because the knight... Okay, I got it. So, I'm forced to play a move that I don't want to play. This might not be going so well. Alright. So, what do I do about this situation? My king has to run again. Oh dear. Wait, no, I could take here first.
Check.
This is check. Alright. So now I have to survive for the next minute or so. We'll see to what extent I can manage to do that. Probably going to be a close one. Oh yeah, look at that pawn power. Oops.
Check.
Wait, what? How's that check? Oh, right. Ha ha!
Check.
Brilliant. My strategy has come to fruition. We'll say. As opposed to, how is that check? Yeah. I saw that all along. It's just testing you. I think I was going to file a bug report. I'm like, there's no way. I know we tested this stuff. Oh, mouse slipped. Oh, you were intending King B8 or something. Ouch. Ouch. Well, should I feel bad? You must have... Don't know what it is. Unfortunately, I can't go back through the move history, I don't think. I did experiment a little bit with that at one point and just failed on that, but yeah. Honestly, Mr. Crupton's the best at this at the moment. But we can try to learn. I can continue playing all these nonsense openings and just see if I learn anything. Other than maybe I shouldn't be playing said nonsense. Wait, why am I not taking the knight? I'm gonna take that. It looks like a very takeable knight. This variant's been out for a number of months. This variant is older than that. This server has been out for a number of months. Yeah, it's really hard to remember that F7 is in fact defended, so you can't just sack the house against it. But wouldn't it be great if there were puzzles for relay chess? But first I gotta work on getting an engine going for it. But yeah, this has been going, the variant has been called N Relay Chess. Because in theory you could have a piece relaying to another piece and so forth. So the more generic form of the game I think is called N Relay Chess. It's been defined for quite some time. But really it was National Master Zug Addict, or John Chernoff, who helped popularize this. And he wants it to be brought to Lee Chess at some point, and Lee Chess tends to be great at doing a few very focused things and doing them well. It's not quite ready for this level of chess awesomeness. But maybe someday. I would have to make an engine for it. It would be hard. Honestly, it just comes down to that would take a lot of effort to do. And to get it right. You'd have to define how the pieces move based on how pieces are defending other pieces. So it's certainly not a trivial task. Okay, so let's move this back. Try to contest this file. No, Mr. Corrupted programmed almost all of this site. I did help him in some small way with it, but this is his creation. Okay, let's block the file. So we have some interesting pawn dynamics going on in this position. Push the pawn, just to keep that nasty, nasty rook away. Yep, of course. Let's go back somewhere. This is tricky. Because unfortunately I've made all kinds of weaknesses. I guess I'm going to make another weakness. Just to make the base weakness that much harder to strike at. Even if I didn't intend to release that right away, it's still a fine move. Wait, what is this? The bishop defends the rook. The rook can move like a bishop, but only so long as it's currently defended. Oh. Unfortunately, my queen's not defending my bishop right now. Otherwise, even then I wouldn't have fun tricks. That's kind of lame. In the most literal of senses. Okay. I suppose I'm going to offer a boring exchange. It's probably not going to accept it, because it's too boring. But he might. I'm prepared for that. Oh, I also accidentally defended against a couple threats, so that's pretty cool. I finally see, yeah, that was his hidden motive here. But I actually successfully defended against that unintentionally. So I'll take that, chalk that up as a win in my book. If only my king were on a different square. Well, let's take care of that. And now set up the cheapo. Alright, am I ready to release the cheapo? I think so. Here we go. There's the cheapo. The rook can only move vertically and horizontally. Oh wait, no, it can still move diagonally. Because the queen defended it. Well, that didn't quite work. I gave up a pawn, attempting to do a cheapo that didn't work. Let's see. Let's just bring the queen out, not threaten anything in particular. Oh, okay.
Check.
Aha! Okay. I tricked him. Or he fell for it. I'm not sure. Either way, good game. I'm not sure if he fell for that on purpose. Just due to the time situation, it could have been fun to do that intentionally. Though it was probably an accident given the time situation. But yeah. Alright, I suppose Corrupted's up for another challenge, so we'll see if I can muster something. Alright. There we go. Take one of those. Yeah, I'm not really sure what I'm doing here. Oh, the bishop's defended. That tricks me every time. I'm like, he's just hung a piece. Wait, no, it's defended. Never mind. Every time. It's the most trollish good play ever. Okay, we're going to block the center and not hang all our stuff. Okay, bishop defends bishop. Yeah, we're trying to bring back relay chess, guys. One day we'll somehow successfully revive it. Okay. This is confusing. Why is relay chess so hard? Like, I even need to ask. Okay, we're gonna exchange these bishops. And then develop this. Yeah, it's a great variant, and I do appreciate that Zug was trying to popularize it. So that's kind of between that and between Mr. Corrupted coding almost all of this. That's why I have to come back here from time to time. Yeah. So. Wait, what? Oh, he's intending knight f2 or something, maybe? Not sure. Either way, I don't want that there anymore. I like this position. Oh, I missed knight h4. Which could have been good fun. Let's defend the knight. Oh. Yeah, he actually has to defend f3. I'm making a stronger attack than I'm letting on. Not intentionally, but... So... What do I do? It seems so ridiculous to play some of these moves, but I'm not sure what else to go for. Yep. Oh, right, that's all defended. My empty threats are recognized as such. Okay, let's defend the pawn. Okay. Keep developing. Seems okay, I guess. Knight h4. Oh, maybe it was winning a queen. Maybe. Now, does king takes pawn win a pawn? Or does it lose the game? Or does it do both? Stay tuned for next episode. No. So... Okay, let's defend the pawn. Yeah, my position's falling apart. But, you know, I still have some ideas. Wait. Wait a second. You know I do all the crazy berserk stuff if I can get away with it. I'm not sure if I can here. But I had to try. Oh. There's some real threats here. So let's defend those.
Check.
Actually, that's still mating.
Check.
Yep. Classic mating too. Rook h6, king g7, queen e2 mate. Oh. Oops. Well, okay, that's what I get for trying to play interesting moves. Doesn't quite work so well. Here's MC. Let's see if we can confuse MC any more than he can confuse us. Yeah, that's okay. I can still win at some chess variants. Maybe. Maybe not.
Check.
Oh, there's the check, guys. Oh. Shit. That's not good. okay. We're losing an exchange. This could have... I mean, it looks disastrous, but... Apparently, that opening has some element of danger to it. So yeah. I'll have to keep that one in mind. That's actually really clever and makes me feel pretty dumb for not seeing it. Goodness. Okay, let's just take the center by storm.
Check.
Okay, I saw knight f6. I didn't see knight f7. I'm just... wait. Out of sheer necessity, I found a good move. Why is this game so tricky? Alright, we defend the knight. People would normally play bishop d7 to defend, but we're not normal. Oh. Wait, there's a hidden threat here. You still got this thing, and then this thing. So I can't do bishop takes. I have to do pawn takes. Actually, I could do bishop takes because then my other bishop defends the center. But I'm just making things confusing, aren't I? Wait. We're playing relay chess. So basically, if a piece is defending another piece, everything moves all weird. Here we go. So, yeah, like, that queen was defending the bishop, so the bishop got to move like a queen. So I'm compacting all my pieces here, which doesn't have much of a benefit. Other than I'm not going to forget where they're at. So there's that. But okay, let's do a rook lift. Because why not? Also, it looks intimidating, so it might trick him into castling. As if castling were a bad move. I don't think it is. It is cool, though, that I have, like, one of each piece type. And two bishops. So, I can pretty much... Oh, he intended to play king takes rook. So, I don't know, maybe I'll be nice. Right, because otherwise that's just considered a king move. Because, I mean, that's a perfectly legal king move that you did there. There's still no takebacks implemented on the site. We don't necessarily need them. And plus, the game's pretty damn complicated anyway without takebacks. So, sometime far in the future, we might implement them. But in the meantime, the official rules page does suggest how to castle. Wait. Oh, he took my knight. Now I don't have as many knights as I used to have. Okay. In fact, let's move this bishop over. So this was defending the bishop, so it got to move like a rook. Alright.
Check.
Well, that might stop the pawn, maybe. that is one fast-moving king. Yeah, queen g6 could have been cheeky. I'm going for a more direct approach, apparently. Queen g6 might still be on the docket. So, this threatens the a pawn. Tactics do start to get tactical here. Right, let's take the pawn. Oh, this isn't as clever as I thought it was.
Check.
Fortunately, it still works. King takes queen! Ha ha! The least predictable move. Nobody ever sees king takes queen.
Check.
Okay. Let's get the king out of here. Or do we, like, double back? Probably not. Gotta say, king takes queen is a pretty great move in this variant, though. I mean, who wouldn't want to play a variant where the king can move in all kinds of fun ways? Alright, so let's defend the king. And reel it back on home. Fine, I suppose I'll take the pawn.
Check.
And then back to g6. Alright.
Check.
Well played, MC. It's gonna take a little while to get the hang of things. But if it's any consolation, Mr. Corrupted's being the pants off of all of us tonight. Yeah. So he's finding a lot of interesting tactics. Yeah, king takes queen. It's something you'd never think about in a normal chess game. Oh, we got two games in progress. We got one game in progress. All right. Yeah, I gotta say, this idea of just b3 and fianchettoing the bishop and putting the knight in front of it seems really powerful. Like, in all the
Check.
times I've tried to fianchetto pieces, I've never gotten anything nearly as effective as that. It's incredible how powerful that is. Takes rook, maybe? There we go. Now, the only consolation black has here. Oh, I mean, yeah, black didn't have to resign. King to h8 seems to trap the rook. No, actually, it does trap the rook. So, black actually seems to come out okay there. The king h8 is not your first move that you look at there. Actually, no, king h8. Rook takes f7. Rook is escaping somehow. King f8, rook h7. So, jeez. That's crazy. Wow. Yeah, remind me not to fall for that trap. Okay, we got Zvish here playing a game. Yeah, but king or queen a1 runs into moves like e5 or f6 that undefend the rook. Yeah, but still, I guess too much was hanging on the king side. Let's see. With three games in play, that's amazing. Okay, one game of the century coming right up here.
Check.
Right, but the problem is
Check.
that the rook, at the end of a move like f6, the rook is no longer defended by the queen, and therefore is no longer checking the king. Okay, well, this opening is pretty tactical. Oh, jeez. That's so merciless. Like, a more merciful opponent might have played, like, knight takes bishop, but no, queen a8. That was cool. It's too bad Black's king is on e8, or rook takes rook could be pretty powerful. So, yeah, I'm trying to calculate this. This is complicated. In part because White's king gets a lot of mobility. Okay, so there's some thread of logic to knight f6, but Yeah, this is where it gets complicated. That pawn on e7 is pinned. So, otherwise, pawn takes bishop could be cool, but yeah, you know, the pawn's pinned at the moment.
Check.
Yeah. And b3 and b6. I'll have to start doing that more. This is relay chess, where a piece moves like the pieces that are defending it. So we saw like the rook on a1, which was defended by the queen, took a pawn on f6. And we'll probably see many other complicated things until some pieces get exchanged. Alright, so yeah, the key point here is that this is defended, so that's a threat. So white had to step out of the way. Yeah, don't worry. You'll get the hang of it, Railbird. I think anybody can master this variant. And maybe one day I can make an AI capable of playing this okay. It might be easier to program this in an AI that's not Stockfish than in Stockfish. Yeah. It's always difficult to remember that king takes the checking piece is often a viable defensive maneuver. I'm guessing pawn c6 is the easy way. Yeah, pawn c6 just gets out of most of the threats there. Yep, that's the only sensible move there. And now white's kind of lucky that it's kind of lucky that his pawn is in fact on d3. Where that pawn elsewhere, it could be difficult for white to protect squares near his king. All right, we've got an attack here. Still, I wonder.
Check.
Okay. It's not exactly what I was looking at, but interesting. Oh. Could we be going for some kind of endgame, I wonder?
Check.
Ouch. Yeah, I was earlier wondering if black had played like f7, f5, trying to push his pawns toward white's king. What would have came of that? But we'll never know. Obviously, you have to be... Oh, wow.
Check.
Yeah, there it is. There's the skewer. Although black's king is highlighted. Yeah, I'll have to fix that. Okay. Now note, it is not easy to checkmate a defended king.
Check.
Alright, MC's trying to go for the mate in the next 19 seconds. 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, or 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, I'm not sure if I was just late in seeing the timer tick down. Maybe there was more time pressure than that. Oh, shoot. Seriously? Ouch. Dang. Dang it. I do admit this is a bit more difficult to test than the Lee Chess code. What do we got here? What do we got? We've got a link to a screenshot. Yeah, I'm gonna share the link. 1 second. Or yeah, Zwish also managed to share it. So you tried to pre-move the promotion or something and it doesn't auto-promote. You have to select the piece. Oh, okay, I see. Dang, I did not know that. I have not had the fortune of promoting a pawn. Your reaction is totally... No. I mean, that's a totally normal reaction. And I would think that... one could blame this as user error and... I think we've all learned how it currently works, but that's not to say that I can't improve it still. Well, I would go so far as to say, just steal the thing that Lee Chess does for the whole promotion stuff. Lee Chess's promotion interface is pretty great. We could probably steal that. I think that handles auto promotion pretty well too, and it's something we could do, I think. Yep, promoting to a knight could be useful, so that's kind of why I hesitate on that auto promote to queen idea. But borrowing the Lee Chess promotion interface would probably be a good thing. Alright, so what's the plan? Oh, okay. Here we go. Let's take one of those. Yeah, you could make some pretty wild openings in this variant. Alright, we're gonna get rid of that bishop. I didn't take d5 because the bishop defended it. The thought did occur to me and I wait, that doesn't work. Otherwise, I would have taken it. Yeah, the idea of holding down a key. I don't know, I think there are cleaner ways to do it. Oh! Well, no, the knight was busy pinning the e-pawn. So I needed the knight here, but I didn't see that the rook defended that. So bishop takes, rook takes, queen takes. Oh, and then knight takes, because I don't need the pin anymore. Yeah, so it would have worked out, in fact. You're right. And I needed all those things defending that. I just didn't believe it would work. But no, you're right. That would have worked. That would have been a free pawn. Almost hanging my entire army, but not quite. I would have been able to exchange, what? A knight and a rook to get a queen and a pawn. It would have been a good exchange. Assuming that he had to take it. And that he would capture back. And that those were the best moves. There might have been something better somewhere in there. For either of us. See, now it's pretty clear I should just take d5. Like, this one seems really clear, unless I'm getting mated. I have to add that onto the end of every evaluation, because I tend to get mated a lot. But hopefully I'm right this time. Alright. So the rook defends this. A lot of stuff is defended here. It's really troubling. Okay, so I'm gonna interfere with that. This is ugly. This is so ugly. Maybe I sack an exchange. Maybe that's my best way out of this. Because I'm seeing some things that I really would rather not have happen in the game. Oh, wait. My entire position's collapsing in a most embarrassing fashion. Right, so don't lose the queen.
Check.
Okay. So this is what I meant by giving up an exchange. That's clever.
Check.
Probably should have tried King H8. King H8 would have been trickier. Okay. There we go. Yeah, unfortunately, rook d5 was not quite legal there. In general, I do recommend using an increment, because these time situations can get pretty stressful. even more than normal chess. So increments tend to be really useful. Especially as we're still learning this. Alright, let's check this out. Whoa, that king. That king is somewhere special. But I actually kind of like Black's position. Not sure what happened this game, but that's pretty cool, whatever happened. Yeah, then that's a queen trap. Well done. Very well played. Well, I said it was a queen trap. I might have been lying. Oh, is he gonna see it? Is he gonna see it? Let's see. Dare I point it out? We'll see if he spots it.
Check.
He's going for something more ambitious.
Check.
Not sure if this works.
Check.
Sure as heck looks ambitious, though. Wait. Yeah, no, I guess this does work.
Check.
Go, 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 go. Oh.
Check.
Oh, that's a pity. So close. So close. No, if bishop g5, the rook can't take on g5. If we had a bishop here, how could the rook move there? The rook's not defended. There's a bishop in the way. That's what makes that tactic so beautiful, with the king over here. Bishop g5 check would fork the queen, rook, and king, and leave white completely helpless. Oh, checkmate, black is victorious. That's got to be a user interface bug. Yeah, no, I've got to fix that check thing. So it's showing the correct result. Oh, that's mate. Wow, okay. Well, now I just feel dense. Yeah, well played, Railbird. None of us know how that happened. But yeah, your bishop defends that. Your rook defends that. Okay, I can get rid of some of these arrows, which are a bit much. So, that's defended, that's defended, this is defended, that's defended. And the knight's got that. Suppose you don't need that. You have, like, the knight here. But yeah, the fact that this bishop defends the pawn... it's pretty key. So. Very cool. Yeah. Mate in one puzzles. Like, I didn't think b5 was mate, but I thought it was still the best move. You do b5 and then just, like, bring your rook over, and there's no way this king is surviving. Black's got all of his pieces cooperating, which in standard chess would be enough, but in relay chess is just overkill. But yeah. Well played. That's actually mate. Jeez. How about that overkill? So yeah, the next time a move occurs, this board will refresh with the latest position. Is my understanding. There we go. So yeah, we got this at Zvish versus MC.
Check.
Ooh, it looks like MC's ahead a solid bishop. Yeah, b3, bishop b2, knight c3 is really powerful. I suspect that something like a hedgehog or something where black plays like f6, d6, e5, just to really blunt that diagonal, probably has some power to it. But if you don't play some really solid formation like that, you have to keep your wits about you. So F6 and King F, well, maybe that is viable. It seems really slow. I hesitate to recommend that because you still need to develop your pieces. But yeah, F6 and King F7 could be viable. Your king might even be better on E8 than it is on F7. Just because the king on E8 is well defended. Yeah. Might have to take away the NM title until he remembers how to castle. I'm joking. No. Also, I've got to give, like, Zug's Addict a special title of Z or something. Although he's National Master, so... yeah. He gets to keep his National Master title. Still, I gotta give him, like, that special Lee Chess trophy somehow. For helping produce the soundtrack, if nothing else.
Check.
I was gonna say, wait, can't we just take on E1? King E8? King E8? King E8. Or White just resigns. That works too. Alright. So. That's a lot. Yeah, King E8. It's just such a silly move. It's not the sort of thing you would typically consider when you're like, oh, my rook's attacked. I better move my king on the opposite side of the board to defend it. Hey, look. We got a game in play. The question is two knights and a bishop versus a rook. I'm guessing that having two pieces is almost always better than having one piece. It probably doesn't matter too much what the pieces are, in terms of being able to win end games. Still, King and Rook versus King and Rook, whole new ball game. All new traps. Just have to be really careful. Or if you're playing King and Rook versus King and Rook, just shuffle your king back and forth across the entire board a few times until your opponent's like, okay, I've had enough of that nonsense, and you agree to a draw. Like knight and bishop versus rook. Yeah, no, knight and, like I said, having multiple pieces probably
Check.
wins over having stronger pieces. It's probably only when you have like a queen versus multiple pieces that things get complicated. Actually, I think that if I had to guess, a bishop and rook are probably better than a queen. But I don't know. Unfortunately, you cannot stack your pieces. That's a different variant. Two bishops and knight versus rook. Yeah, that's gotta be an easy win somehow. Whoa, okay, is that a fair exchange or was that a sack? I stopped paying attention because I'm tired, but I assume that's got to be a fair exchange, right? Or why would. No, that looks like white's going down a piece. I don't understand.
Check.
There must be some trickiness here. Now, of course, I would play king takes bishop, but I'm silly. It's probably really dangerous and ill-advised to do that. But how dangerous? How ill-advised? Maybe he's thinking about it. There we go. Okay, now the question is, will Zwish attack this bishop by first playing this? He plays that, then this does that. Although I don't know if that level of sophistication is necessary. But it almost spells out like a Z backwards. So, I don't know. Either way, I think I might wrap it up after this one. Obviously, I'll leave the server up and running if people want to play on it. And spectating mode finally works so people can watch other people play, which is really cool. So you can learn from the greats, like Mr. Corrupted. Yeah. I'm sure eventually we'll get Zug hooked on this again. Although he still wants to see it brought to League Chess. And I do at some point, I just recognize that it's a lot of work for this to be brought to League Chess. Now I do realize or recognize that League Chess is making leaps and bounds with their UI making it perform a whole lot faster.
Check.
And rewriting parts of it using TypeScript. So, you know, I might strongly consider, I don't know, taking advantage of these rewrites and seeing if I can inject in some high-performing code to generate piece moves. Well, if only Black could like win the rook, that'd be cool. Easier said than done. But yeah, the other thing is, I'm not sure how much Lee Chess would want this, but that's not for me to decide. If they don't want it, at least I could run it on my own instance if ever I figure out how to code it. But I guess I got to start by putting all the piece move rules into Scala so that we have the server-side validation of the client-side moves. And then I need to have the client side probably using the same like chess ground code, generating all the legal moves, detecting pins and interference moves and so forth. Yeah, he said no more variants.
Check.
So yeah, he's not open to discussing it at this point. That doesn't mean I couldn't put it on at least my own instance if I were to code it.
Check.
Yeah. I don't know. Racing Kings is hard. Well, I'm sorry, Racing Kings has one hell of a learning curve. And I think the fact that we have a Racing Kings engine will help people learn it better and enjoy it a bit more. So they can like learn how to play openings and get some really basic training from the engine on how to play it. But yeah, it's got the really, really sharp learning curve. What is the definition of a draw? I think if your opponent has just a king, then if you time out, it's a draw. Yeah, anything more than just a king can checkmate you. Yeah, but like, if you think Racing Kings is so simple, try it against Stockfish. You'll see that the idea of moving the king forward is not always so easy. That said, I mean, Racing Kings is not my favorite variant, but there is some depth to it, and I think once people are better able to train and learn on it, then maybe if there's ever a training module released for the variant, maybe it'll become more popular. I'm not sure what else could help popularize it. Maybe taking trading some pieces out of the start position for other pieces. I'm not sure what.
Check.
Ah. Oh, that's a typical. This is going to be a race. This is why you use an increment.
Check.
Timeout. White is victorious. To the victor go all the spoils. That's why you use an increment, guys. But good game. Very exciting. Well played. Ouch! A mouse slip on a pre-move. I've done that before, particularly with this mouse. It's not the best of pre-moving. Anyhow, feel free to continue playing. The server will be up and running. If there are any issues with it, I'll reboot it or whatever it takes to keep it up and going. Later this week, I'll get around to fixing the check king highlight bug. So it shows the it highlights the king who's actually in check, as opposed to always hiding lighting black's king. So I'll fix that. Some point I'll try to get a working move list going, but I've got so many other projects at the moment, so I can't guarantee anything just yet. You know. Also, don't forget we do have a Discord server for the people who want to discuss this. So again, go to the link relaychess.org, and from there just click on the Discord link, and that's an open invitation to anybody. So I'm sure people will be willing to help train, teach, whatever. I do like how the rating list came out here. So you can see your rating plus or minus an estimate of twice your rating deviation. So that's a 95% confidence interval. Telling us that your rating is probably that estimate, that parameter X or mu, plus or minus twice the standard error. Technically, scientific experiments typically do like plus or minus 2.95 or 2.96 or something times the standard error. But we just picked two because, I don't know, it inspires some more confidence in the estimates, even though it's not necessarily as accurate as we want to believe it is. Yeah. So we're saying there's like a 95% chance your rating could be, or your true strength could be 1869. Could also be 702 points lower than that. Yeah. Could also be 1167. So I really like how that turned out. And that way you could see like everybody's rating estimate is just an estimate. I mean, that's all the rating estimates ever are on any rating scale. Yeah, I'm pretty glad with the way this turned out. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Hope you had some fun. I do hope that Zug has in some way succeeded in popularizing this variant. Yeah, it's certainly more informative than a question mark, and I think it was too much information for some of the people at Lee Chess, but I think we can handle it because we're all adults here. Maybe. maybe not. Anyway, yeah, thanks for watching, and see you next time.